My name's Mary Portas, and for the last few years, I've helped small independent retailers. But now, I'm taking on the high street. And this time, I'm working for you.
We see queues at the cash desk, staff that ignore us. Enough is enough.
I'm tackling some of Britain's most complained about customer service culprits.
Westface has actually become the new south-facing.
I'll show you how to demand better.
You have to complain.
Not get ripped off.
This doesn't seem to work. Why doesn't it work?
It's not a real phone.
This week, I'm taking on one of your most complained about industries. As a retail shopping experience, that is just hideous.
Customer service, I think, is incredibly poor.
You're turned off by the salesman.
I'm not exactly good with phones.
I just put my head on the desk and hit it.
And you're put off by the jargon.
There's a lot of rates, minutes, gigs.
But getting them to put you first will be a battle.
If you want to buy a TV for your woman, you do usually let the husband deal with it.
You're not listening, you're telling. And that is the problem all the time.
It's not broken, don't fix it.
Why do we put up with this kind of service in our country? Mobile phone chains have taken over the high street. Last year, they sold 30 million new phones, but after used car salesmen, it's the most complained about retail sector.
When you go into the shop, you tend to be bombarded by all this stuff. You don't really know where to turn, and you just want someone to sum it up for you.
The millions and trillions of deals, there's too many.
There's a lot of technical jargon, a lot of rates, minutes, gigs, RAM, ROM.
I think they're more interested in actually getting a phone sold than they are in actually getting any degree of service to people.
It's just not good enough.
Why do we put up with this? You know, why do we put up with this kind of service in our country? What is wrong with us?
I want to fix the problem, but first I need to see how bad it's got. I'm going shopping undercover.
God, I suddenly look like my Auntie Margaret.
I want to see how phone shops serve technophobic shoppers.
I'm coming in from a very low knowledge base. I want someone who's going to work with me, advise me, and hold my hand, actually, and give me the best phone.
But I found the same problems that drive you crazy. First, the walls are plastered with baffling stats and offers.
I'm completely at a loss.
Second, the salesman can leave you dazed and confused.
And you also get 500 megabytes of data, which is a lot.
What does megabytes mean?
It's hard to quantify it. It's like money.
Third, in many stores, you can't try before you buy. On the walls, just use these bits of plastic on a piece of string.
I write, it's not a real phone.
Oh, okay.
Basically, you go into a shop with a counter, whatever bloke gets to you first, and they're all blokes, and they're all kind of techie blokes. You think about the cost that people spend on mobile phones. As a retail shopping experience, that is just hideous. I found the whole thing just, draining. Now, I want to work with a high street chain to address these customer service issues. I asked for volunteers. One accepted.
I think buying a mobile phone is a very difficult experience. That is one of the challenges we've got to overcome. How could we possibly make it a pleasurable experience to come into one of our stores and walk out with a phone?
Phone House has 50 shops across the country and wants to open another 80 this year. But owner Clive is a serial entrepreneur with no previous experience of the industry.
I don't know much about mobile phones. I got into mobile phones by mistake.
Back in the 70s, he was in mega rock band Yes.
That's one of my guitars, which I have just in case I think of a rift. You know, got to have a bit of percussion sometimes if you're playing the guitar, so I get behind these sometimes. And when T-Mobile calls me or Vodafone, I pretend to be over there at my desk, but I'm on the bongos. But they don't know that.
Old rocker Clive turns over 20 million a year, but says he's not in it for the money.
Our ambition would be to have a good retail group out there doing something different and being a lot of fun. And in fact, Phone House is easily transposed into Fun House, which is what we call it.
My secret shopping showed fixing the customer service here will be a tall order.
Yeah, I would choose a Black Rover over anything.
And why is that?
I just know how to use it.
Yeah.
I'm not exactly good with phones.
Yeah.
Doesn't it work? What's the point of having it there if it doesn't work?
It's not a real phone.
Oh, right, it's not a real phone. Oh, okay.
And you don't have any demo versions?
I had the Wildfire demo. I'll find out where I put it.
It's not just me who had a terrible time.
The customer service was very poor and I didn't really trust the sales assistant that was helping me.
It certainly is not inspiring and wonderful.
I wouldn't buy a phone from there if... Honestly, in my honest opinion, I won't buy a phone from there.
I want to take a closer look at Clive's shops. He doesn't actually control most of them. They're franchises, independent shop owners who pay Clive a fee to use his brand, but run the shops as they see fit.
I've come to Waltham Cross Station to meet H. Apparently H is the top salesman for Phone House. And he's a franchisee. So I need to understand that. I want to see what the shop's like. I want to see how he sells. And he told me, don't worry, I'll pick you up from the station. So I'm waiting here.
I have a funny feeling that the state-of-the-art Lamborghini coming down the road might be my lift. Last year, H's shop turned over £1 million. As a franchisee, he keeps the profits for himself.
You have to train yourself physically and mentally to prepare for the day, to look after your consumers, your customers.
H's amazing sales has made him a leading figure in the Phone House chain.
Oh, H!
Hi, Mary.
Lovely to meet you.
Wow. H from Waltham Cross will be showing you around today.
I'm in the wrong business, obviously.
So, I mean, this must be... I mean, you must be so successful at what you're doing to be driving a Lamborghini.
No, definitely. I think my secret is I treat my customers like I want to be treated. So, luckily, with my experience and how good I am, as people tell me... I heard about yourself to say you're nearly as good as me. So it's a pleasure meeting someone.
Who's nearly as good as you?
Nearly as good as me, same calibre.
H talks about customer service, but does he really deliver it? His shop front isn't anywhere near as slick as his pattern.
Hi Mary, this is my Phone House. This is where it all happens for me. Post my life.
Hello, are you H's brother?
Yeah, you must be Mary.
Yeah.
Mary. Nice to meet you. How are you?
I'm very good. You two suited and booted dudes.
Yeah, we try to keep the standard, absolutely.
The shop's so dreary, but the boys take their appearance very seriously.
Well, wearing a tie, it defines a clear relationship between the customer and the supplier themselves.
When I'm working, I like to have a double knotted tie.
Yeah.
Thick, not completely small like they're doing German Street, because if I feel restricted, if I feel as if I'm trapped, then that's going to be expressed in my technique or the commitment or the experience the customer has.
So you've got your big tie, and then we've got H with his chest out. So tell me the psychology
He's the boss.
But Mo doesn't just excite shoppers with his dress sense.
Just to see little things like that.
Yeah, go on.
I'll just pop in and roll in, but you can't really dance properly in shoes. I need a proper bit of training so I can...
God, your body's like rubble when you do that. Do it again. Come out here. Right, I'm going to just see this.
Entry level, I don't. Dance 101. Easy.
Right, dance 101.
That's simple. You can just pop and grind and...
These brothers are fantastic, but the fact remains, it's a bog standard store.
We've got a uniform of a shop, so when you walk into one of our shops, you'll find it's pretty much the same. Like an estate agent will always have plastics,
with houses for sale will have plastics with accessories for sale.
Who wrote that rule book, though?
I just think it's uniform. Everyone follows.
And that's where I think the biggest problem is. I think they're doing themselves a disservice, because I think that look of that shop, I know he thinks it's lovely, but it's not. It's the same old graphics, phone, boxes piled up in the window. Actually, I think there's customers crying out there saying, don't be like the rest of them. H claims to provide great customer service. He's good at selling, but does he listen?
What I'd recommend for you, first of all, is a booster you can buy. You can have unlimited landline calls for £5.
Do you ring landlines? I bet you don't.
No.
Do you know half your friends' landline numbers?
No. You'd be quite surprised, maybe, but half the time these women sit at home, make themselves look pretty, but they're on the phone at the same time.
Not many people have got landlines.
Why would you give her unlimited landlines when she doesn't ring her mum on the landline?
No, I'm just giving her the options of what the unlimited we can sell for the lady.
I don't think they want a landline package.
Why would you want to waste your 900 minutes calling her mobile when you know for £5...
But H seems determined they should have one.
I think it works out about 13p a day. If you was to have this as it is today, so you had unlimited landline calls, unlimited T-Mobile calls, unlimited texts, 900 minutes to call every other network as well, that comes to a grand total of 40.
These customers have no chance of getting the right package for them until the salespeople just stop the hard sell and listen. Now, H, he has bags of charm and aftershave. He knows how to sell. The problem is he doesn't know how to listen. And that's the biggest issue that I have to tackle with him.
I am the top salesperson in Phone House. I actually introduced myself at their Christmas party. Hello, my name's H, I'm the best. I don't think no one can improve me. I think I will learn as much as I want to. So improving me is probably a no-no.
Coming up, service at its worst.
I just thought the service was crap.
It's just the most boring sales. I have to just put my head on the desk and hit it 3 times.
And I try to tame the unruly salesman. The most important thing is the question.
Certainly.
You're not listening, you're telling. And you're assuming. And that is the problem all the time.
We just went bollocks to this. It's just crap.
The mobile phone industry makes millions, but they could be doing more for you. I'm Mary Portas, and I want to champion a better customer service approach at the Phone House chain.
If we can find something to make us different, that's something I'm seeking for, and maybe Mary can help us find that. I hope she can.
I've been to their shop with the best sales. The second shop Clive wants me to work on is one of their worst. In Angel, Islington. There's someone I particularly want to meet in this one. He came up pretty badly. In fact, terribly, in the undercover filming. I'm laughing because it was so terrible that I am laughing.
Not exactly good with phones.
Yeah. Have you got any phones that I can take a look at?
The one we've got, one of the guys at work here is actually using it for himself at the present time, just due to the fact that his mum stuck his washing machine.
The customers are hardly wowed.
The customer services, which was really poor by the shopkeeper.
We weren't acknowledged immediately when we went in. It took a little while before any of the staff noticed us.
I just thought the service was crap.
Customer service here is clearly failing.
Could you just go through various BlackBerries that you do?
The BlackBerry curve is this, has it here. With the £20 a month contract,
right.
You will get 300 minutes, 300 texts, unlimited BlackBerry services. If you've got a BlackBerry personally, your son, any other relative, mm-hmm. You could have a chat between all of you for free.
Oh.
Okay.
You can have this, or you can have that. It's just the most boring sales. I have to just put my head on the desk and hit it 3 times and walk down and give my customer elsewhere. I'd like to know what Dean the manager sees in Matt. How did you offer him a job then?
We had a vacant position come available in our Woolworth Road store. And obviously Matthew had been telling me that there wasn't much
job satisfaction for him.
How did you know him, then?
This is my son.
Oh, he's your son?
He's my son as well, yeah.
Yeah, is he good?
He's learning. He has shown that he's got the potential when he actually can sell.
I believe that any customer coming into this shop deserves better service than you've given them. So, I'm going to train you for the customer. Okay?
I'm petrified, to be honest.
No, you're not. Don't talk rubbish. We haven't even started, love. What are you petrified of?
Oh, you. Sorry, but you really intimidate me.
Oh, Matt's actually quite sweet. But this shop needs some serious tender loving care.
There is no life, there's no soul. They're all kind of just like walking into a techie library without any knowledge, any advice. I found it just really dreary. What have I put myself in for?
Time to report my grim findings to Clive.
What I've experienced is blokey drivel in really cold, boring, actually just depressing environment.
Truth is, I don't think Clive's got a firm enough grip across his franchise shops.
It all feels quite boring. Where is the feeling of this is my vision and this is Clive's vision and this is what I want to give to the people? I don't feel it, honestly.
I've got to say you're wrong on that one. So I've put a lot of effort into this business. I am passionate about it. We've made this business survive against incredibly difficult odds. It ain't been easy.
I think they've got a name above a door. I think they've got a name above a door that says Fan House. That is not a brand, Clive. That is not a business with soul.
There is soul in this business, and I completely refute the fact that there's no soul.
I don't feel your hand on this business. I wouldn't open any more stores until you've got that sorted.
Clive wants to open 80 new franchises by next year. But unless something seriously changes, Clive will be opening yet another 80 uninspiring, very boring shops. I need Clive to realise there's more to this than just getting shops open. They need to work in a completely different way.
Whatever she comes up with is going to help us if we can implement all of it, half of it, part of it. It's still going to improve Phone House.
The mobile phone companies may be making billions, but the macho sales culture means customers are often pushed into buying products that don't suit their needs. Phone House is full of men who don't know how to listen.
Morning, boys.
Morning.
Are you ready?
Sure.
I'm going to give them a lesson from an industry that couldn't be less macho. Female beauty.
This is Fiona. Fiona, this is your crew. Please don't run away. If Fiona was talking all that techie tosh that you lot talk at half the time, looking at you, because you're not the worst.
Not the worst, I'm the best. You keep getting it wrong, don't you? And I think selling skincare nowadays is a lot easier than what we do. But anyway, we'll entertain you.
Oh, do you hear
we'll
that?
Okay. You, we?
As with mobile phones, cosmetics customers need guidance through the complex product range, but they get it without the hard sell.
For us, it's all about the customer. The customer is the most important person.
That's how we make all our money.
And what we need to do is we have to really listen to what the customer needs. So that's our first most important priority.
We sign up customers for 24 months, and these your skincare product can stop using after a week. With ours, it's stuck with 24 months, so our job's more important.
But you've got one skin, and your face is for life.
Oh, no, of course.
Listen to it. Come here. This is a man who has his eyebrows done, I can tell. And if I'm not mistaken, he has his chest waxed as well. And he has his hair beautifully done. Look at him. He smells like a little baby. So don't tell me you're not interested in this.
No, we are. No, we're
great. I think you are.
We have, first of all, the product, which is our top-selling moisturiser of all time.
I'm going to make these guys take over from Fiona. I want them to prove they can listen and work out what their customers need. First up, top salesman H.
Take a seat with us.
Okay.
What would you like to achieve with your moisturiser today? You look great anyway, so
oh,
you don't need
thank
much.
You.
What would you like to
I've
achieve?
I've got rather thin red skin, so I'd quite like something that would calm my skin down.
I'll probably say the 3-in-1.
More questions.
Oh, right, okay, sorry.
What do you do in the morning? How does your skin feel in the morning? You've not asked Penny any of those questions. We really need to understand.
Anyway, forget that. Have you got mobile phones?
Next up, Brother Mo tries a charm offensive.
What are we actually after? Do you mind if you just take the glass off so I can have a look around your eye area as well? Because normally it's this area around here that you're more likely to show lines of ageing and stuff, you see.
It's not. I'm 22. I'm not ageing yet.
That's weird.
No, it's the dryness.
Just the dryness itself.
Yeah, it's not wrinkles or anything.
No, absolutely.
Not yet.
No, of course not.
But the most important thing is the question.
Certainly.
You're not listening, you're telling. And you're assuming. And that is the problem all the time.
Finally, it's Matt's turn.
Morning.
Morning.
How are you today?
Fine, thank you.
Okay. So, I'm going to ask you a few questions. What is it you're actually looking for from your moisturiser?
What I'm looking for is something for my eyes here. A sort of tired look here. I want something to brighten.
Okay. Have you got a routine in the morning? How you would moisturise?
Yeah, I would put moisturiser on and then I'd cleanse and then put my makeup on.
So then you do use the cover up, which do you seem to find it dries the skin?
A little bit, and as I
maybe I've underestimated young Matthew.
A product that I would probably recommend would be this product here. Mm-hmm. It's a muscle relaxant, really. It's like a Botox. It's got the Botox theory behind it, but it's a natural.
You know, if you don't know induct, you'd do really, really, really well.
Brilliant.
Would you buy that?
Yeah, I'll buy it.
You've made a purchase! Yeah!
I like the bit at the end.
Who did it the best out of who we've seen so far this morning, genuinely? Matt?
Yeah.
He listened.
I don't think I've learned anything new today via the moisturising industry. Definitely not, no.
Some of the guys here is just like, oh, you know, we're the best at what we do, so why would we take advice from someone if we can do what we're doing already? It's big-headedness, to be honest. It's really big-headed.
I'm blown away. Really? He sold the product. He gave the right one. He actually listened. Oh, this is the guy who was at the bottom of the pile. I want to know why Matt's potential hasn't shown before now.
Is there any area in the job that you've been finding hard?
I don't know if I've got that confidence that I can go up and just start a conversation with someone and then develop from there.
Mm. Maybe where you feel you've got to do the sale is a pressure, whereas if you genuinely approach this customer wanting to give them the solution because you have the knowledge, that puts you in a much more confident and powerful position. You know, I know a lot of people think I'm confident, but I had years of feeling desperately unconfident. There's an awful lot of very young people in retail who don't ever feel confident in talking with customers. And often customers see it as just arrogance or rudeness, but often it's just deep down insecurity, shyness and lack of confidence. And I think that's what we've got here. You know, and actually he's a really sweet guy.
If I can stop Matt thinking he needs to hard sell, I think it'll help his confidence. But lack of confidence isn't the problem at the franchise in Waltham Cross.
Taking some mobile phone guys, especially of our calibre, to sell face cream, I think it was a little bit out of order. We just went bollocks to this. It's just crap. We shouldn't be here. It's a waste of our time. It was a bit demeaning going somewhere and someone saying to you, hang on, this is how you sell, this is how you relate to a customer. And I think that's what really pissed us off.
Coming up, I unveil my master plan.
This sums up the phone business to me. A bunch of blokes.
But some will take convincing.
It'd be very, very hard for her to improve what we do in our shop. Unless she was to come and clean my office.
We spend a fortune on mobile phones in this country. 89% of us own one, and we have a right to expect better customer service.
The customer service, I think, is incredibly poor.
Instead of selling them something that I actually want, they'll sell me something completely different.
Jargon's a whole different language, and I personally don't understand it.
So I went undercover as an unsavvy shopper to see how I would fare. My experience at Phones for You was bewildering. The walls were crammed with products and offers.
Completely at a loss.
Could the salesman help me make sense of the best deal? I said I had lost my phone and I wanted a new deal. How many minutes would they offer me for £15 a month?
£15 a month? Yeah. On T-Mobile?
Yeah. Where you want?
You'd get 100 minutes. 100 texts.
I'm not interested in the internet. Is there a good deal to start just using the phone?
Is there a deal for £15
that
gets you 300 minutes?
£15.
And don't worry about the internet and all those modern things.
Phones for You told me there was a plethora of offers available in their store for £15 a month. But I was offered only one.
£25. You get 600 minutes.
£25. Has he been listening?
I thought this would be quite straightforward. It's not, is it?
The manager gets involved. He wants me to spend £20 a month. He tries to throw in extras to seal the deal.
How long is that hold for?
So I don't get a £15 deal, and this old granny decides to leave empty-handed. They sit you at these horrible little grey tables, and all the guy did was flick through the book to see what the tariffs were. I think it's hard sell done by a gang of blokes who have no interest or understanding of anybody's lifestyle other than their own. And when it comes to flogging you their phone insurance, some salespeople are surprisingly reassuring.
They'll cover you for everything worldwide.
No mention of any exclusions.
And that $9.99 would just cover everything. So you just
What about the exclusion if you leave the phone in a public place?
Yeah, you're covered.
If I leave it on the bus or something. Okay.
This industry needs change. That's where I come in. I've tried to teach phone house sales teams to listen better to customer needs. Now I want to fix their shops.
Good morning, how are you?
Very well.
Did you get here easily?
Yeah, sort of.
CEO Clive owns 5 shops in the chain, including the Angel branch, and he's brought the staff. The remaining 45 shops are run by independent franchisees. To make a difference to the high street, I'll need them to change their shops too. I've invited leading member H on their behalf.
It's going to be a big surprise to us if she does find a way to improve the business, to improve the look. Being the best as well, it'd be very, very hard for her to improve what we do in our shop. Unless she was to come and clean my office.
So far, we've got H, Mr. Know-it-all. I'm sure he'll have a big opinion. Mr. I can run the world.
Come on, let's see what Mary can deliver.
Are you had difficulties getting in to see me?
Yes.
Grab a seat over there. Hello, Mary Portas.
Oh,
this sums up the phone business to me. Blokes. Mm-hmm. A bunch of blokes. I think that the genre of phone retailing is a very techie, very masculine world.
If you want to buy a TV for your woman, you do usually let the husband deal with it. It's the same with mobile phones. Mm-hmm. It's like us men with babies and kids and household stuff. We'd rather go to our wives and our companions and say, look, could you help me out? I don't really understand this. They're really masterful at it.
What can we do that changes the psychology, a new model, a kind of what I want is a new social experience?
My vision is a phone shop like they've never seen before.
What I want to do, first of all, is to start to put these benches in where people can sit and people can socialise.
I want Phone House to feel relaxed and welcoming.
So I love the idea of really opening the place up, creating all your sidewalls as seating areas as opposed to just dead. In the middle, have a beautiful display of every phone possible, and it becomes a place where you look in and you actually think, gosh, this could be a cafe.
To solve the problem of confusing shop displays, my final concept is to lay phones out in a new way.
This customer can come in and see roughly what phones are for them, OK? Yeah. Phones which mean business. Yeah. Quite simply, these are the best business phones. Phones to talk and text. These are the teenagers. We know that's all you want to do. These are the best for those. Mm-hmm. Phones without all the fiddly bits. I love that. Mm-hmm. Oldies. You don't want anything too high-techy. Phones with style and fun. The fashionistas.
Looks good. I mean, personally, I like it a lot. And it's different. The name Phone House, it is a house. You're making it look like a house, a welcoming place. What I would say to you is I'm really happy. I'd like to try that and see what happens.
Clive's on board, but H isn't for turning.
It looks a bit too... A bit too comfortable, a little bit too homely in there. I want to go into a shop where I've got a counter, I've got a chair which we can sit in, and for 20 minutes they're being served. They're not waiting around, like, clicking their fingers or, come on, someone help me out. So the experience in our shop is great.
So you're saying that you think that your customers prefer perched on a stall up at the cash desk with you rather than maybe sitting?
Probably, because they're getting undivided attention, like all of them do.
Clive really got this, and that's fantastic. But the problem is, most of his business is franchise. That's the big problem here. And I'm not hearing any love from the franchisees, number one being H, at all.
Mary's actually come across saying she's going to revamp and start from scratch. And this is why we have to look at the cost effectiveness. It's a practicality we have to worry about.
But H needs to realise that better customer service will give him an even better business.
H has got the upper hand and the Lamborghini. H is, you know, making the money. Don't mess with my business model, mate. Under that lovely little smile, there's a man of steel.
Clive can see the potential advantage of doing things better.
Great ideas. It's the right way to go. And it makes us different.
He starts rebuilding the shop he owns himself in Angel.
To be honest, I really can't wait. I mean, it's a brand new shop. It's really like a brand new start.
H remains unconvinced. He chairs a meeting of the franchisees without me to discuss my ideas.
What she's come across is to say to us, we should look like this. Okay.
But I'll be honest, it does look dull. The first impressions?
It's not very eye-catching. I mean, when you first look at it, first glance, you think, not too sure.
What Mary's actually come to us and said, we should have different areas with five different sections.
Not practical.
OK, not practical.
Not quite convinced on the whole idea. It's not right for Phone House, because most of the Phone House stores are franchises. We're all working for ourselves. We've all got, you know, it's our businesses, and it might not, maybe we'd have to really invest some serious money.
I like it. There's something quite appealing about it as well, but it's, the practicalities have to be worked out.
When I asked the partners today, how many of you are willing to pay £20,000 to £25,000 for a refit like this? Unfortunately, none of them put their hands up. We really need to see if it does work in Angel.
Everything now depends on the Angel branch. I need to prove that delivering great customer service can mean even bigger profits. Oh, boys!
Morning.
Hey, how good does this feel? Oh, it's so lovely seeing you both sitting there like that as opposed to behind the counter. It's so good! Right? Then these simple little signs which tell you what phones mean business, phones to talk and text, phones with the X Factor, and phones which can do everything. So for the old techies, no other phone shop looks like this, does it?
No.
I love this setup. I really, really, really love this setup.
But a great setup isn't enough.
When you start, and this is your new way of selling, it's, hello, all our phones are out here. All of our phones you can use, and the difference is I'm here if you need me.
Yes.
People don't want hard salt, they don't like it. They like someone to be themselves.
Definitely.
Right, yeah. I'm watching you. No, I'm relying on you, Matt. Now smile and let's open up the shop. Right. Hello, come into the store. Please come in. Hello.
Afternoon, ladies. How are you?
Thank you.
Yeah? My name's Matt. How are you? Can we help you today?
I was looking at getting a BlackBerry.
Look at Matt feeling much more confident. They're sitting down, they're relaxed. He's there, he's showing them bits that they don't know, how to use it, but he doesn't have to do the hard sell.
Thank you very much.
No problem. Have a nice day.
Yeah, you too.
Matt was very helpful. He came and approached me and told me about all the services that I needed.
So that could be from O2 to Orange to landlines. Now I'm feeling a lot more confident. See, before it was like, make the sale. Even if you're wandering around just asking people, are you okay? How are you? It's just making customers feel welcome.
Instead of useless bits of plastic, this shop has live phones on display.
To be able to come in and actually sit down and when you're trying to find a phone, to try them and not have the dummies.
I know. The dummies drive me
potty.
Here we've got people of all ages, you know? Teens, 20-something, old-age pensioners, middle-aged women, all coming together and all playing and using this. I love that. Clive arrives to give his verdict.
Wow.
Isn't it great?
It's fantastic. You've done a great job. Really superb. Great environment, good feel. It's relaxed too.
Yeah,
it's relaxed really atmosphere.
But Clive's only half the battle won. For people to know that you've changed the business of phone selling, you need the likes of Mr. H to be doing this.
I agree. We need his buy-in.
Today we're going to go and see Mary's design. I'm still a bit dubious about if it's going to work or not, in the way of if it's going to be practical enough for our industry. It's going to have to take a lot to blow me away.
Here goes.
Looking lovely.
Thank you. So do you. Do you think the style of much more relaxed selling is right for a phone business?
I've been a firm believer, if it's not broken, don't fix it. If it needs improving, improve it. But don't improve it so much that people don't recognise you. I actually walked through the high street and I was like, where's Phone House? We have to make sure we move everything with us and not leave anyone behind. So we have to be very careful at Phone House, how we change it.
You're right.
Little changes.
You don't want to be left behind.
But in the big way, I would never be left behind.
You're old school now.
Well, yeah.
You are old school.
Yeah, 15 years I've been in the industry and I've seen it. And if we sit down together with your experience in perfecting things and our experience in the mobile phone industry, I think we can come up with something so great, it'd be unbelievable.
I've come up with it.
You've come up with it, but I think there is some nitty-gritty practicalities we do have to look at together.
H's shop, to me, was absolutely the old face of phone retailing. You know, the counter, him in his suit looking all sophisticated and well cut behind it, him with all the knowledge, imparting it to you, advising you. I don't want that anymore. So for me, him changing is actually probably the most important part of this jigsaw. I've been tackling the hideous customer service you receive at some mobile phone chains. So far, I've overhauled Phone House's flagship store in Islington. It's been trading under the new regime. New contracts and upgrades are up by a third, proving good customer service is an all-round winner.
I thought it was great. I thought it was really very friendly, very welcoming.
Loved it. Loved the feel. You feel quite daunting in those sort of places, but I felt comfortable in there. I didn't feel out of my depth.
Clive, the boss, wants to roll out my plans across the chain. All the shop owners need to agree, but one has been dead against my ideas. H has been resisting me the whole time, in a very H, wide boy, cute way, but he's resisting me. Really, this is my final meeting, trying to convince him. And I'm really hoping he'll agree that the redesigned Islington store is a vast improvement on his shop. Morning!
Hi!
Good morning.
Oh, you know what? Sorry, H. But I come in here and it just feels so dated, don't you think?
I'm about to show H what he's missing out on.
When I started doing the business, I did a survey of customers. I asked them, would you make Phone House your brand of choice? And 80% said no, pre the shop. When revisited, 97% said yes, which is phenomenal. You've now seen the concept, you've worked with it. What are you going to do with it now?
We've reinvented ourselves, we're on the high street and we're going to roll out. So for a new partner coming to Phone House, that's the brand. The difficult bit now is to take that brand and roll it across our existing partners.
So with Clive's backing and the customer feedback, is H ready to take the leap?
I think it looks brilliant. Like I say, the concept we've got is brilliant as well, but you probably find 60 to 70% of our customers are happy dealing with us with like it is, and 90% will be happier dealing it with your concept because it will just give them a better experience. But like I say, the concept that we have at the moment, it's obviously been working because we've grown as a business.
H still hasn't given me a straight answer.
H, are you going to do it?
Yes, no, definitely. Your concept's great.
And hey! So you're going to take it. I am going to see H with his shirt open, yes, with tables in here.
With tables in here, yeah. And you're more than welcome to come down for a coffee.
The thing is, you have great passion and knowledge, H. You really do. There's no way you could take that away from you. But I genuinely, genuinely believe by embracing the customers, letting them play, letting them really think about their lifestyles and really making it a much more social, relaxed shopping experience, you will do even better. So out with all those pink boxes, down with all these posters. I just feel excited to see this rolled out, you know? I really, really do. No, wonderful, wonderful news.
After visiting the new store, Angel, I think it just everything fell into place and it was a lot more clearer, and you actually do see the customers enjoying themselves.
Let's do this.
Over the next 12 months, my new concept will be rolled out across new and existing stores in the chain.
We will make
Thanks,
it
Mary.
Work. Nah, it's been my pleasure working with
Thank
you.
Thank you.
Ooh. A real pleasure.
This is so big for me today because H has always been the toughest nut to crack. There's no two ways about that. He has his reputation. He has the car. He's made it. So for him to say, no, I am going to listen, I am going to change, is massive. And good on him. I've changed one chain, but I want to make an impact on the rest. So today, me and my gang of disgruntled shoppers are going to take the phone shops by surprise. Phone shops seem unwilling to give us independent and transparent advice. They confuse us with techie speak, jargon, and these price plans. What are my big phones doing?
I better not press anything with a zero in it.
If stores don't provide great service, we'll do the job for them. I want customers to hear some facts before they buy.
Do you know that normally the average user only uses half their 3 minutes?
Did you know that you could probably insure me a lot cheaper on your home contents and insurance than by using the mobile phone industry's insurance?
Phone industry makes £13 billion a year from your unused minutes and texts that you pay for.
Think before you buy! Think before you buy!
Phone tariff users waste 1,862 texts.
Phones for You said they have clear in-store navigation and training, sales and compliance processes ensure a consistently good customer experience. Staff undertake assessments of customer needs and always demonstrate an actual handset before sale. Carphone Warehouse say they offer 100% impartial advice and incentivise employees to offer the best possible service, so any recommendations are purely in the customer's interest. They serve 150,000 customers a week in the UK and are confident the incidents highlighted in my secret filming are not usual.
How much am I?
Can I ask if you've got permission to be filming in the store?
No, then I'm going to ask you to leave, unfortunately.
Next week, I'm taking on estate agents.
A bit slimy,
wise guys.
And I don't trust any of them.
Yeah, these cracks, and God, they don't tell you that in the write-up, do they?
West Face has actually become the new South Facing. Because
it's smoke and mirrors.
It's not
smoke and mirrors. It is because
Mary.
But you want the sale, it's you want the job. Are people in this country being served by estate agents?
Looking for answers in East London, Phil and Kirsty aren't getting many. A relocation from Bristol at 8 tomorrow. And at 9, Foreman Jim's getting more and more annoyed with the team. Rome wasn't built in a day.